Niles?
Yeah, man.
You look... Did you get hit on the head by a coconut?
The coconut of revelation. I discovered a whole new side of myself in Belize, and I'm not going to abandon Island Niles just because my vacation's over.
Well, Island Niles might want to rethink the short pants.
Island Niles would prefer not to wear pants at all.
Put it on speaker.
You do the talking.
No, Daphne should.
I don't know what to say.
Hello? Hello?
The most dangerous part of a gecko is its mind.
What are you talking about? A gecko's brain is like this big.
But a cricket's brain is only this big.
I'm going to work now. I'll be home late. Don't wait up.
Great party, Frasier.
Oh, thanks. Glad you could come.
Dennis.
you too.
Emily.
Say, when are you expecting?
No.
This weather to change.
Oh, how lovely. One moment.
Wait, you're hurting me.
That's because you keep fighting me.
You gone?
The chair! Oh my God! Oh, here, Niles, hand me this drop cloth. I'll smother it.
Be careful.
Quickly.
Just.
Oh, look out, God!
Look out! Dr. Crane's moods never last very long. I'm sure we've seen the worst of it.
Oh my, that's. I don't know.
Yes, well, I thought you might like that.
Yes, I'll have to do some rearranging, but don't worry, I'll find some room for it somewhere.
I thought that was a window.
Yes, well, it was.
This is so awesome, and I promise I will not let you down. I'm gonna soak up as much as I can from you. I'm gonna be like your shadow. You and me, Dr. Crane. From now on, you know we should probably carpool to work.
Now, can I see you for a moment?
No.
I need you both to be as hungry as I am. Are you hungry?
I'm starving! Me too!
Great. Call my office Monday morning and we'll go over the details.
Wow! That was my... very first locker room pep talk.
Mine too.
She took your pants, you know.
I know.
All our lives, Dad's been the guy in charge. I just hate to see him powerless like this.
Well, how can you call him powerless? The minute you saw him, you ran into a storage closet.
That's true.
You're a grown man. You're still scared of him?
Well, you're a grown man. You're still scared of him too.
Yeah, well, at least I have a girlfriend.
Shut up.
Immerse yourself in the spectacle and the grandeur that are these United States, this America.
How did you do that?
Cam Winston!
Who's made her own life and her own decisions. Now, I plan to shack up with Niles here, and damned if we aren't going to do it every night of the week.
Will you marry me?
Oh, Niles, of course I will.
He mopped up soup kitchens, he read to bedridden veterans, he even went to the Galapagos Islands to help clean the oil off some fowls.
He said that, did he?
It's been a long time since Frasier was excited about somebody. Kind of miss that spring in his step, you know? The nervous energy he gets where every first date might be the one. The electricity of that 30-point self-inspection before he rolls out of the showroom.
Hey, you know how to spell loser? C-R-A-N-E.
You don't have to worry about ever seeing him again, son. Chances are he'll end up at a state school.
How? You. Can you take him?
Yeah.
Then spell his ass off.
All right, careful.
No.
All right. Oh. I can't see anything.
No,
it's not there, is it?
Well, I don't know. Hang on a minute.
What?
Hang on. Wait.
Yeah.
Wait. My God.
Yeah.
There's something.
Careful.
Hang on. Here it is. Oh.
What is the meaning of this? Where is his mate?
I'm sorry, I don't know what you're talking about.
My favorite pair of socks reduced to a single argyle. Nor is this the only example. The keen observer yesterday would have noticed that I left the apartment wearing two shades of black. Explanation, please.
So, Carla, how you been?
Well, two of my kids are in jail. The bank's about to foreclose on the house, and after tonight, I'm never going to see Cliff Clavin again. Things are great.
Yeah, Carla was never really a fan of Cliff's.
Well, not to talk the guy down, but he's a big blowhard who thinks he knows everything and never shuts up.
Imagine.
Go ahead, caller. I'm listening.
Go back to Seattle.
How was the level on that? We will always be friends, Frasier. Nothing's gonna ever change that. I can't believe you traveled all this way.
Oh, that's what people do when they care about someone.
My name is Niles Crane. I'm planning to marry your daughter.
You look okay to me. All right. You have my blessing.
Thank you. But actually, I'm here to reunite you with your wife. Oh, Mr. Moon. Oh!
So that's how it goes. Two people get married, they're together 40 years, and then all of a sudden it just ends.
But it's different from you. I mean, you found the right person.
You barely know him.
Well, all I know was I threw him out my pub 6 times, and 6 times he marched back in and yammered me ear off until I went back with him to America, all to make you happy.
I can't spend one more second without being your wife, Niles Crane, because I adore you.
But I thought you always wanted a big wedding.
You want to make my dreams come true. This is my dream.